What up, the Droid 52 here, the power of Kazakhstan, and today I bring you some Russian power episode 5. And today we're gonna be playing with RPD, which stands for Ruchnoy Pulemet Dikhtyareva. And it's been in service in 1944 till 1961. It got replaced by Ruchnoy Pulemet Kalashnikova, in other words is RPK. And I know it got dropped off Soviet Union pretty quick, only 20 years, but still it is used by many other countries. Used by China, Korea, North Korea, I don't think South Korea uses it, some other Asian countries, African countries, South American countries use it. And as you can see, the RPK didn't die, it's still alive. Now let's go instantly to characteristics. So, it weighs 6.6 kilograms or 14.55 pounds, which is kind of heavy, but still, it's not heavy as some machine guns. Its length is 1037 millimeters or 1 meter and 3 centimeters or 40.8 inches for those who use inches. The barrel length is 520 millimeters and 20.5 inches for those who use inches. It uses cartridge 7.62x39mm, which is kind of AK round. Well, it is an AK round. Also, it was used in DP28. The action is gas operated. Rate of fire 650-750 rounds per minute, which is pretty good for the machine gun, in my opinion. Muzzle velocity 735 meters per second, pretty fast. You can kill people pretty easily. Effective range is 100 to 1 kilometer. 100 meters till 1 kilometer with size adjustments, so you can adjust if you want to shoot 100 meters or you want to shoot 1 kilometer or something like that. Feed system is non-disintegrated 100 round segmented belt stored in drum container. So basically a belt that is stored in drum container or either a box container, doesn't matter since it is a belt, and the belt magazines can be stored in many different ways. Sights are open sights with rear sliding that can be adjusted to 100 till 1 kilometer. Wow, that was a mouthful. Now let's talk about history of this gun. So it was created in 1944, just before the war is gonna end, you know, which World War II. And it was actually the same maker that made the DP-28, Dikhtyarev. And Dikhtyarev made a pretty good gun. Also, he had to compete with three designers to make RPD, and he won. So he was accepted into Soviet Union Army to create arms, actually, and he mass-produced RPD in 1944. Well, not him alone, but it was mass-produced. But he got withdrawn in 1961 because of new machine gun that replaced it. It was RPK, also Kalashnikov-type weapons. Many new Kalashnikov style weapons were more powerful than the older ones, so they decided to modernize their army. But RPD still did not die, it's still used in many countries. Some of them are Egypt, Congo, Cambodia, and some other third world countries too, but still, it is used in many countries. Also, it manufactured in many different countries. It manufactured in North Korea, Egypt, China and Poland. The RPK was actually a first tester of its own round. It is 7.62x39mm, and as you know, it is a AK round, and it was its first test. And actually AK-47 was made for that round, not like the gun made and then they picked a round. It made for that round, so that pretty much explains that. And that was a kind of between a rifle and a submachine gun rounds, and it was perfect for the machine gun because it can shoot both rounds. Usually a machine gun is the gun that can shoot rifle rounds much faster than a rifle. Another reason why RPD got displaced by RPK is because RPK was much accurate and it was easier to manufacture than the RPD. RPD, there were more details than RPK. RPK was basically a AK-47, just increased barrel and the shots and stuff like that. So it was easier to manufacture than the RPD, and it had a better accuracy over the RPD, so that's why it got displaced. One thing I think RPD has over RPKs that it uses a belt magazine. Like with belt magazine, you can put as many ammo you want into the belt, but with not belt, you pretty much limited into the space of the magazine. Like if you have a drum magazine, you limit it to that space, or if you have a normal like a stick magazine, pretty much limited to that. And that is kind of bad for RPK, but still, it's a lot lighter gun compared to RPD. RPD was pretty heavy for comparing to RPK. This concludes my episode 5 of Russian Power. And RPD is a pretty good gun, but it got displaced by RPK, but still used by many other countries. There've been a lot of conflicts since it dropped out in service in Soviet Union. And that kind of shows that RPD is very powerful gun, and it's really good at suppressing fire and making your troops advance. And it is pretty good gun, shall I say. And I have about 30 seconds left. One thing, shall I say, please give it a like, because it's really hard to make those videos, especially RPK, because there were not too much information on it. And the next gun is gonna be the AN-98 on Battlefield Bad Company 2 original version. And yeah, thanks for watching. The Droid52 is turning off. And one more thing that I gotta say is I hate World War Hackers, because they ruined that game, and I cannot do 2 or 3 more guns that are in World War. Thanks for watching. The Droid52 is turning off.